The Jewish people, Jewish people, are not the real people of the book.
That's right.
They're Khazarians, yeah? They're Edomites. Edomites.
Do you mind if I put them over to
the you can do if you want. Let him argue it. But his own people have described it. They've already told on themselves that they're not the people of the book. So this is going to be interesting. Get a little debate going.
You have Jeremiah 14:2, Jeremiah 8:1.
Mm-hmm.
You have Psalms of Solomon 1:5. All these things. Plus, you have Isaiah 29:22, where it says, "The children of Jacob will never be compelled."
Mm-hmm. Is it? I don't remember that one.
Yeah.
What was it again?
It says, "God says the Lord who delivered Abraham and the house of Jacob." It says, "Jacob shall not now be ashamed, neither shall his face wax pale."
Oh, okay. That goes along with the President Nasser of Egypt saying, that they can't be the Israelites because they left black and they come back white. So, is he having trouble? Okay, here we go. Hello there.
How are you?
All right.
Listening to your claim story.
Oh, you're not going to participate then?
I don't know what you're saying. I didn't understand what you're saying.
No. I was just going to say on camera, do you want to talk about whether you guys are the real Israelites of the Bible?
I wasn't happy. There's not much, I don't see much of a debate in it.
Really? So
I'll tell you why.
Why's that?
It's a quick point, that's why. I can trace my heritage back to Abraham.
Okay, how?
To my father and my mother from Rosa. I don't know it by heart. I'm telling you now.
What about
now.
Jacob?
What? I can go to Abraham, so I can go to Jacob. Because it goes through Jacob.
Okay.
So I can trust. So I've met you. What, you a black Israel, Hebrew?
A Hebrew Israelite, yes.
I've met before. I don't think there's much of a debate. I hear your logic. I hear where you're coming from logic. I understand the logic.
Mm-hmm.
I'm David, by the way.
I'm David too.
Oh, awesome. I understand the logic, the scientific, that black people are more from the area, well, white, as myself, Caucasian, so to say, are from more European. And I hear the argument, I do. I totally understand the argument, and my simple answer to that is, I can trace my heritage.
So where in your heritage were your people taken into slavery for 400 years? Any time. Where in your history?
Which 400 years?
Any 400 years. When was
you talking about in the Bible?
No, in history. Where in your
life? Where are you getting number 400 years from?
In your heritage, any time,
yes.
Has your people been in slavery and affliction, yes, for 400 years?
Where are you getting number 400 years from? That's what I'm asking.
No, I'm asking you a question.
Why 400? That's my question to you.
Well, because that's
it says
that's
in the Bible.
Okay,
that's what I'm trying to understand where you're coming from. So it says in the Bible we believe that we were in slavery in Egypt for 400 years.
No, that was 430 years.
What?
430 years, and that wasn't for 400 years because Jacob,
Joseph.
Joseph was a dignitary, honored guest, and all his people were honored guests in Egypt. Lived in the best part of the land, yeah, until Joseph died, and a new pharaoh came up, and then they got enslaved, and they were only enslaved for the life of Moses, yeah.
No, so that's not even it.
No, if you look, Moses was a baby when the affliction started. Moses was
Exodus 12:40. He explains the 430, but then if you go to Genesis 15:13, it's only 400.
Right, but
two different slaves.
But the point is, okay, it wasn't 400 years that they're in slavery for, yeah, right?
Never mind.
So the slavery happened after that.
No. That's all right.
So when were you enslaved? Were people in slavery and affliction?
So we count the slavery from when Jacob came down.
So when
Jacob
in your history was the Jewish people enslaved for 400 years?
So I'm telling you, we count slavery from when Jacob came down to Egypt. That was while Joseph was alive.
They lived in the best part of the land. Goshen was the best part of the land. They were dignitaries. They were honored guests there.
So
it was only after the next pharaoh.
I understand what you're going. I understand. So
after Joseph died, right? a long time after Joseph died, because that pharaoh had no idea who Joseph was. Yeah?
I understand your point.
So that was that after that.
I understand your point. Now, can I answer?
It wasn't 400 years.
So we count the 400 years, and in, please let me finish, David.
I don't care what you count. It's what the book says.
And I'm trying to explain. The 400 years starts. So your question is, so why does the 400 start when Joseph was alive? We still were dignitaries. That's your I'm trying to answer. The point is that the reason is because we were in spiritual slavery from when Jacob got there.
Spiritual slavery, because you know what? No, they were honored guests. They were invited.
Spiritual.
Spiritual, because you know what? When Jacob died, his people and Egyptians went to bury him. Okay, it was a huge event, and. The Pharaoh said, yes, go, take all your family and wives and go, and there's not slavery, yeah? Sorry, that doesn't count. When were your people ever in slavery?
All right, so you want to...
Give me an example, an actual answer. Don't fall back on that lie.
No, I am, and I'll tell you why.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Well, that's what we count. You could say it doesn't count as slavery in your books, and which you're entitled to.
Because that's the 400
count,
years.
We count spiritual slavery as slavery.
In the end times. Egypt wasn't the end times.
It's the end times. Right?
The end times, because Hosea 3 and 4 and 5 says that for and I can't quote these things, but it says... For many years the Israelites will go without ephod and teraphim, which is the priestly garments and everything.
Talking about now.
Yes, and in the last days, right, that David will be risen up and they'll go back into the
which
land.
Which talking about now, in exile, which the Jewish people are.
They're not in exile.
Why are
they Who's
not?
In exile?
I am.
Well, I'm sorry, there's all these Jewish people in Israel right now, occupying the land of Canaan right now.
Okay, and
are they in exile? Who brought them into Canaan?
Have you ever been to Israel?
Who brought them into Canaan?
No, I said so many times you've gone there. I'm going to divert for a second. I'm going to get back to your point. I'm going to divert for a second. I've said this in regard to the Israel-Palestinian conflict. So I'm just bringing it in for a second. The people in Israel use Judaism as an excuse to claim the land. They represent nothing Jewish. They're not Orthodox Jews. They don't follow the book. They don't follow. And I'm going to give an example, which is not what I believe should be the law. For example, homosexual same-sex marriage is legal in Israel. Now, I'm not advocating for stoning of people if they're gay. I'm not God's policeman. God can do what he likes. But if you were claiming to follow God's laws and claim to be the Jewish land, you would stone gay people then. You would stone adulterers. Do they do that in Israel? No. Israel uses Judaism when it's convenient to claim the land as God has sent us. We are from an ancient people that sent in exile 2,000 years ago. God has sent us here to take claim the land and everything else. I've been to Israel many times, okay? Saudi Arabia has more to do with Judaism than there has follows more Jewish laws than Israel does. So it's not proof that we've taken the land. The people of the Jewish faith have taken the land, not Jewish people.
Right, so what do you say about the claims that of your own scholars who say that you guys aren't the people of Abraham, Isaac, and
Jacob?
I don't
know what scholars you're talking about. If you show them...
Shlomo Sands, The 13th Tribe by Arthur Koestler.
Are modern Jews descendants of the tribe of Judah, one of the sons of Jacob? Are European Jews really Gentiles whose ancestors converted to Judaism? The facts are clear now. That most of those who call themselves Jews are not descendants of Jacob, whose name was later changed to Israel, and therefore have no claim to the land of Palestine. The October 29, 1996 New York Times, in an article entitled Scholars Debate Origins of Yiddish and the Migrations of Jews, states, the Eastern European Jews were not really Semitic, that they were largely descended from the Turkish Khazars, who converted to Judaism in medieval times. Therefore, modern Jews have no blood link to the biblical Israelites. Jewish historians have established that at least 90% of all Jews come from a Turkish mix of people and are largely sourced from the Khazar kingdom. The Jewish scholar Arthur Koestler provided overwhelming evidence in his book titled The 13th Tribe, showing that in the 8th century, Khazaria, which was greatly made up of the Turkish mixed people known as Khazars, converted to their national religion of Judaism, which was based on the Babylonian Talmud. He states in his book that the Khazar Empire, which in the Dark Ages became converted to Judaism, Khazaria was finally destroyed by Genghis Khan and his Mongol hordes, but evidence indicates that the Khazars themselves migrated to Poland and formed a Western Jewish community. They eventually migrated to other places like Germany and Russia.
Christian churches and the general public have been deceived. Many Jewish historians are now admitting that they are not the true Hebrews of the Bible. And how can they be returning to the land of Israel when they were never there to begin with?
The goal of creating a homeland for Jews seemed like a noble pursuit in 1897, when the Zionist movement became officially established. However, their dream of returning to Palestine has become a nightmare of violence, and there is no end in sight. Worse yet, the concept that Palestine is their homeland has turned out to be a tragic mistake. These white-skinned Ashkenazi Jews are not descendants of the original Jews of Palestine. There were no white people in Africa or Palestine 2,000 years ago.
In 1976, Random House published a book that should have hit Christians like a storm, but instead, they chose to ignore it. It dealt with the racial origin of the people calling themselves Jews, and whom the churches and the Jews themselves generally insist are God's chosen people. Since the late 1800s, a number of Bible scholars who were also students of history have insisted the church denominations were wrong, that instead of being Israelites, these Jews from Eastern Europe descended from Mongolians that were actually Turkish people who had adopted Judaism as their religion over 1,000 years ago and had become known as Jews. These Bible scholars were ignored or condemned and often called cultists or anti-Semites. The 13th tribe proves beyond doubt that modern Jews are not biblical Israelites. Every church member in America should insist that their pastor investigate these claims. Henry Ford, founder of the Ford Motor Company, assembled a staff of experts to research the origin of European Jews who had been entering America in large numbers since the 1880s. Ford's research cost him several millions of dollars, and in 1923, he published the results in a four-volume work titled The International Jew. It was Henry Ford's conclusion that the Jews were not descendants of the biblical Israelites. Ford further proved that these Jews, committing all sorts of crimes while under the cover of being called chosen people of the Bible, were rapidly taking economic and political control of America. Henry Ford also claimed that the Jews had secretly gained control of most Protestant seminaries and Christian book publishing houses and had been able to remove almost all criticism of Jews from Christian literature. In summing up his findings, Henry Ford stated, "The Jews are not the chosen people, though practically the entire church has succumbed to the propaganda which declares them to be so." Ford's book caused a major uproar for a few years, but soon disappeared from colleges, universities, and public libraries, and became unobtainable at any price. The churches continued to teach the lie that the Jews are God's chosen people, the children of Israel. Jewish-dominated news media began to refer to Jews always as Israelites. Anyone opposing the Jewish control of the nations was immediately branded anti-Semitic. And Jewish-dominated seminaries taught new ministers to quote Genesis 12, verse 1 through 3, and sternly warned their flocks that anyone speaking unfavorably of the Jews would be cursed by God. Jewish control of American society, politics, and religions continued to increase. In 1951, retired U.S. military intelligence officer Colonel John Beatty published a scholarly book titled Iron Curtain Over America. Colonel Beatty gave overwhelming evidence that the Eastern European Jews were actually Khazars and had no racial ancestry in Israel at all. In Colonel Beatty's book, he states that by 1951, these Jews had a stronghold on American politics, on banking and credit, on all sources of news, on the entertainment industry, on America's education system, and that they were the predominant race as judges, lawyers, doctors, and organized crime. The Jewish news media refused to review the book. Jewish book dealers refused to handle it. Christian bookstores ignored it, and only a few thousand copies were distributed. Most Americans never heard of Iron Curtain Over America. Now, because of renewed interest, both are now obtainable. In 1977, Colonel Curtis B. Dahl published a book titled Israel's $5 Trillion Secret. He was the former son-in-law of Franklin Delano Roosevelt and a personal acquaintance of many high officials in the U.S. government since the 1930s. Colonel Dahl proves again, from reliable sources, that the Jews are not Israelites. In fact, Colonel Dahl calls their masquerades as Israel the greatest hoax of the last centuries. It should be read by every non-Jew.
Now, what are the facts? The Jews, I call them Jews to you because they're known as Jews. I don't call them Jews. I refer to them as so-called Jews because I know what they are. Especially our Lord and Savior was not one of them. And I can prove that. Now what happened? The Eastern European Jews, who form 92% of the world population of those people who call themselves Jews, were originally Khazars. They were a warlike tribe that lived deep in the heart of Asia. And they were so warlike that even the Asiatics drove them out of Asia into Eastern Europe.
Many Arabs today are aware that these are imposters that dwell in the land, and they want them out of Israel. This is why Jamal Abdul Nasser, the former president of the United Arab Republic, said in 1956 that he could not respect the Jews because they left Israel black and came back white. What are they? They are the synagogue of Satan. Christians don't recognize this because they are deceived. They are sending millions of dollars over to Israel each year, thinking that they are helping God's people, but instead, they are funding the synagogue of Satan. Christian churches and the general public have been deceived. Jewish historians are now coming forth stating that they are not the true people of the Bible, and how can they be returning when they were never there to begin with? I leave you with this scripture. I know thy works, tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them that say that they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. Who call themselves Jews? Who worship in a synagogue? I rest my case.
Okay. 13th tribe that has lots of documentary evidence right. That says you guys are not right. The people. Why do you call yourself Israelis, not Israelites? Why do you call yourself Semites, not Shemites?
I don't. I call myself Jewish. I don't.
Why do you call yourself Jewish, not a Judite? Yeah, because Jewish didn't exist. It's a made-up word. Yeah, 9th century when the Khazarians, right? Khazarians under King Bulan, right, converted to something they made up called Judaism. And they call themselves Jews, yeah? They're not the people of the book.
I'm going to fall back to my first point. I trace my heritage. That's exactly... So,
well, show me. Well, how do you trace your heritage? How? Have you got a book that goes all the way back to Abraham? Oh, really?
I don't walk around with a book. You don't understand that.
Okay.
I would love to see that.
Right? Because if it's based on patrilineal, yeah? I cannot see how your people can trace your lineage patrilineally all the way to you.
I can trace.
And as I remember, you say it's matrilineal. The Jewish go by the mother, don't they?
To be Jewish goes by the mother. The tribe on which you are goes by the father.
Okay. No. So I would...
No, I... What?
And right now, I would love to see that, but we can't go any further with that conversation because you can't show me, what? So I can't see it. So you can make that claim. I can't argue it.
Exactly. I can't.
So you can't really make that claim here because you can't go, okay, here's the proof. And I'm not saying you should have proof on you, but
I didn't come in to make a claim. I was asked a question, that's all. I didn't.
Right.
I'm not trying to, I'm not coming in to preach. So if I had come in to preach, you would write. I didn't come in to preach. He called me aside, some gentleman, and asked me to make comment, that's all. And you're right, I can't prove it to you. And I'm not trying to convince you. I ain't trying to convince you this. You're entitled to your views, and as I tell this to everyone else when I argue with people of other faiths here, one day we'll see who's right. I just believe I am. That's right. All.
And I'm just going by the Old Testament. Right? And the Old Testament is really clear about what a certain people is going to have to go through. Yeah, it says in Psalms 89 that their memories are going to be taken away from them. Yeah, their heritage, their memory is going to be taken away from them. Right? They're going to go into slavery and affliction, forget who they are for 400 years. And at the end of that 400 years, they're going to remember themselves in the land of their captivity.
That's right.
Right? And they're going to wake up and reclaim their own heritage, remember their history.
Professor, right? Just this book of Genesis, chapter 15, verse 3, it says, "And he said unto Abraham, know for surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and they shall serve them, and they shall afflict them for 400 years."
So, like I said, that was from when Jacob went to Egypt. It wasn't his land. So no, you can rightfully claim, and I understand, because you can claim and you have it's in your right. As I was saying, I don't have any books with me. I can't prove anything with me. So you have, but what we believe is that we were from there. We were strangers. It wasn't our land. You can guess Joseph was of the nobility. Was of the nobility there, which I'm not.
Deuteronomy 28:68 says they will go into that slavery and affliction by ship. You can't go.
Sorry. Please let me, I'm going to have to, I've never heard that.
Do you want to look up Deuteronomy 28:68?
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. It says, "And the Lord shall bring you into Egypt again with ships."
With ships.
All right, can you give me, I'm going to check up, you don't mind if I look in the Hebrew.
28:68.
"Thou shalt see no more again, and there thou shalt be sold unto thy enemies, for bond men, and for bond men and for bond women, and no man shall buy you."
Right, again into Egypt. Egypt meaning the house of bondage.
I understand. I'm going to look in the Hebrew. No, mind. Okay. Sorry, give it to me. I didn't. Where is it?
28.
What, Genesis?
68, is it? 28:68.
Genesis.
No, Deuteronomy.
Deuteronomy, you're all right.
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 2. "I am the Lord thy God, which
28 what?
Out of the land 68. Of Egypt, out of the house of bondage."
Right. So, Egypt again, the house of bondage again, by ship. Doesn't mean, you know, it's telling
61?
You, 68, that it's telling you it's not that bondage, it's another one.
This is the book of Jeremiah.
You want to read it out what you said?
I'm looking, give me a second. Oh, yes.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 14, verse 2. "Judah mourneth."
Give me a second, bro.
That's fine. "Judah mourneth, and the gate thereof languisheth. They are black unto the ground, and the cry of Jerusalem is gone up."
Yeah. Black unto the ground. There's another one that says, "Are you like the Ethiopians, the children of the Ethiopians to me?"
Isaiah 29, verse 22. "Therefore, thus says the Lord, who redeemed Abraham concerning the house of Jacob, Jacob shall not now be ashamed, neither shall his face wax pale."
All right, I shall.
Okay, you can read it out.
What? I want to first go back a bit.
No.
I want
28:68.
You came in the middle of a story.
You're just looking up 28:68. What does it say?
Okay, it says that we will go back in galleys into bondage.
Again.
Again.
By ship.
By galleys.
By galleys.
No
ship.
Problem. Let me. I want to show you what it says before. It says you missed our fundamental point.
Really?
It says early on, in 58, if you fail to observe, this is saying what will happen if we don't. This is not saying what will.
And when did that covenant begin? With Moses on the way out of Egypt. If you fail to keep to his law that was given to Moses, yeah, then you're going to. So it's telling you, you've just proved your point, or proved my point. It's a different of slavery and affliction, isn't it? Isn't it?
Correct.
Thank you.
This is the book of Amos, chapter 9, verse 7.
Amen.
"Are ye not as children of Ethiopia unto me, O children of Israel?"
Sorry, what's the Amos? Lots? What's the Hebrew name for that? No.
I don't know. But yes, I knew that one. I don't remember the verses.
Yeah, I'm not able to check if I don't have the Hebrew name.
He wanted the Hebrew name of Amos.
I wanted.
But
you have the English translation.
Amos.
What?
Amos.
There's no book called Amos.
Okay. Have you got the Torah, the Tanakh, right?
I do.
You got the Tanakh.
Yes. I want to read in the original language because it could be a mistaken translation. You understand that?
Okay.
That makes sense to you.
But the point is, the Israelites
do you
were
know
black
about
people.
Joel? After Joel is the book of Amos. Joel, Amos, you know. You have Daniel, you have Hosea, you have Joel, you have Amos, then you have Obadiah. You know Obadiah.
All right, give me a second.
So, but we work for the truth, man. It's for lies. So we do, you can't perpetrate it without lying.
So, you know, why aren't you dressed as an Israelite? Well, if you think you are.
What's dressed like an Israelite, man?
Where are your fringes? Where's your ribbon of blue?
We have to have this. If you are really the people of God, you have to have this. Right? What you wear on your head is called yarmulke, right?
Yep.
Show me yarmulke in the Bible.
It's not in the Bible.
Exactly. So that's Talmudic stuff.
Correct.
That's Babylonian stuff.
I agree.
So did Moses give the Israelite the law of the Babylonian or the law of the Israelites?
He gave God's law.
Huh?
I don't. There's no law. There's two things in what the Orthodox Jew have. We have what is, put it in English, we have what God gave on Mount Sinai. There's loads of laws, like the tzitzit, like you're talking about.
What? Tzitzit.
What?
Tzitzit is, that's a corruption, yeah? Four tassels on the corners?
No.
It's a border, yeah? On your borders. And a border of blue. You can't have a border of blue on a single tassel. It's another Jewish, tradition. That's nothing to do with the Old Testament says.
That's Talmudic. That's satanic.
It's the understanding.
Yeah,
that's the understanding
that
of it.
You understand that it's satanic.
Again, it goes along with the idea that you're Israelis, not Israelites. Semites, not Shemites. It's a deception.
Okay, let me read this to you. Let me read.
Go.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 37. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, and bid them that they make them fringes in
fringes.
The borders of their garments.
Border.
Throughout their generations. Right? And put them upon the fringe of the borders, of the borders,
of
a
blue.
Ribbon of blue.
It's your understanding. No, it's.
Does anybody understand that? Is that plain?
You know.
Anybody?
Can we first?
Does not understand that.
Can we go?
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 15.
Can we go back? Can we go back a stage? And can we first say that?
Okay.
Can we agree the Bible, the Old Testament, was not in English? It was in Hebrew.
No, it wasn't in Hebrew.
All right.
Hebrew, modern Hebrew is Yiddish.
Not modern Hebrew.
Paleo Hebrew. Which is nothing to do with this modern Yiddish.
So what? Again, it was in Hebrew. No, I'm talking about
Paleo
modern Hebrew.
Hebrew.
I don't know what you call it. I don't know what the English name is. My apologies. Could be Paleo.
Paleo Hebrew. Proto-Sinaitic.
I'm going to take your word for it.
Okay.
I think it's not relevant. It's what the name of the Hebrew is.
It's actually very relevant, but
why is it relevant?
Why it's relevant is because Paleo Hebrew is a pictorial language,
right?
That you don't understand with the left-hand side of your brain, right? You listen to it and you feel the meaning, okay? I'll give you an example of how it works, yeah, all right? The good example is, if I'm gonna describe a film to you in English, and you're gonna have to tell me what the film is, right? Okay, and rest of you, try and guess what the film is, okay? A man on the autistic spectrum recounts his life to strangers. What's the film? Rain Man, anybody else? A man on the autistic spectrum recounts his life to strangers. What film is it? Come on, then, guess.
Yeah, I call Rain Man.
Rain Man?
I was getting younger.
Oh, you're Benjamin Button? Okay, anyone else? Okay, right, we're going to, so it's only Rain Man, okay? Right, so I'm going to say the same film, describe same film in Paleo Hebrew. As I said, Paleo Hebrew is a language of pictures. So I'm going to use emoticons, emojis, okay? So, just say it when you hear it, when you get it, okay? Man running, a few trees, box of chocolates, a shrimp, and a boat, yeah? So, what happened there? When I was describing it in English, okay, in the left-hand side of your brain, you were listening to the sounds I was making, right? You were finding the meanings of those words, and then literally matching them up to films. And most of you said Rain Man, okay? Now, when I started showing you the pictures, you didn't have to think about it. All of a sudden, you knew it. Yeah? It came from here, not here.
I have a question.
Okay. Paleo-Hebrew is the language of pictures.
Is this Paleo-Hebrew?
No, that is Yiddish, using Aramaic characters.
All right, no problem. All right, I think now I understand. Right now I understand. Before I did not. I think this is a pointless conversation, and I'll tell you why.
Why?
Because there's fundamentals I thought we agreed on. If we don't agree on fundamentals,
okay,
then it's a pointless conversation.
So do we agree that is not the original language?
No,
of
that is.
So what? Sorry. So vowels and vowel points are original.
No idea what that means. Forgive me.
No, actually,
No.
Can I say something, right? The vowel point was actually introduced in the 7th century, right? It was introduced, and it was introduced by those who you call the Masoretic Jews. The Masoretic Jews are the people who come with a Masoretic lexicon to invent vowels into the consonant of the Paleo-Hebrew. So the Lashon Kodash, which is the Paleo-Hebrew, has been existing even before Abraham was born.
Yes. So I've just got to say, did you know when that modern Hebrew was created?
I want to understand that.
1800s. It was created in the
1800s. You talking? Give me a second.
By Rabbi Yehuda or something.
Yes, it's 770.
Yeah, no, but the actual language using the block characters,
okay, 1800s. Okay, I have a question for you, David. What are you talking about, these or this?
That, because that's Aleph. Yeah, Aleph.
You
agree
the letters are the
no.
Aleph. All right, no problem. I'm trying to say.
Ba, ga, da, ra, pa, la, ja. Yes.
I tell you why I think this is pointless. Okay, I hear. I tell you why I think that.
There you go.
I tell you why I think this is pointless.
It's pointless because you can't accept that language is actually a mixture of High German, with Babylonian characters, invented in the 1800s.
No.
Look it up. It's not mine making this up. Look it up.
I tell you why it's not true.
It is true. Look it up. Go on bloody Wikipedia if you have to.
The British Museum has a scroll they took from Yemen in the 1100s.
Well, maybe Aramaic, yes.
No, it looks like this. Without the dots.
Aramaic,
it looks like this.
Aramaic.
It's a scroll.
Aramaic.
I don't get what you're trying to say.
Babylonian. Aramaic.
Babylonian. You said it was made up in the 1800s.
Yes. Modern Hebrew, Yiddish, the words, were made
up. So how is it the scroll that the British Museum has corresponds with this made up language from the 1800s?
Aramaic. It's written in Aramaic,
written in this Hebrew.
It's written in Aramaic, right? Vowels were added, yes? Because Hebrew does not have vowels. Yeah, there's only an R sound. Yeah? And everything else is made up of R sounds.
We have fundamental differences.
Right, yes, we have.
We have, so I think that...
You've got to look at your history. You've got to actually look at your history.
I know my history.
You don't, apparently.
I do. You seem to think something of my history. That's
so do you know about the 9th century, King Bulan?
No.
No, you don't.
I've heard of it, but doesn't...
That's your history.
It's not, because once again, I can trace my lineage and he's irrelevant.
You're a Khazarian. You are not a Hebrew Israelite. A Khazarian.
I trace my heritage.
I can trace your heritage, looking at history. Right? You're a mixture of Edomite and Hittite. Right? There were two branches. One became the Turkish, and one became the Khazarian.
Like I said, we have fundamental differences, and I think it's very, it's very informative.
Ashkenazis, same lineage, right? And the Germans.
I think talking Jew was very informative, without a doubt. I learned a lot about the Black Israelites I did not know. It's pointless as a philosophical, because we have differences that we'll never agree on.
Indeed. But you know what? There's a book that literally lays out a whole history of a people, right? And you guys are trying to claim that book. You can't. It's not real.
Like I said, I can trace my lineage back.
Well, you can say that.
Abraham. For both my parents.
Yeah, I know.
Abraham was alive, 6,000 years? Between 5 and 6,000 years?
4,000 years ago, roughly. 4 to 5,000 years ago, yeah. And
so have you got the document on you?
You've got a scroll. Is it a scroll you've got, or is it a book? Or what is it?
It's a book.
A book? Yeah. Who wrote that book?
It was received generation from generation.
So it's a 4,000 year old book?
No. The book itself isn't 4,000 years old. They don't have an original document.
So hang on, okay, run me through this, yeah? So you've got a book,
okay. Very
which was published when? When was it made?
It's not a book published or published. I have from my father, but he is from his father. But he is from his father.
So it's 4,000 years old, that book?
No, the book is, you're thinking as a physical object. No, the book...
It's a mental object.
So what's your migration? What is your family migration from England to here? I mean, do you live in England?
I do. So how... Larry Tottenham. Glorious Tottenham.
At the moment, I'll probably not. What is your migration? If you don't mind asking.
What do you mean?
So how did you get to England? What did you come from Israel?
How did I come from Israel? My grandparents came. My grandfather came from Hungary after the war. It goes back. Do I know it by heart? No, because it was never realistic to me. It's never been of interest to me.
Your migration is not of interest.
You've got this document.
Histories is a bunch of zeros. If you put something in front of it, you make it relevant. If you don't, it's nothing.
Alright, that might sound good to you. But what I want to know is, you're standing here and saying that you have your lineage going back. Yeah? Yeah. And when I say to you, where were these people living? What's the migration? You're like, I don't know.
Alright, and as I told him earlier on, I didn't come here to debate. He asked me, this lovely gentleman here asked me to make comments.
But you know what?
If I came here to prophesize, you're right, I'd have to come and prove it. But I didn't come to do that. I was asked to give my personal opinion, my humble opinion,
if I had a document that said exactly where I come from, yeah, I'd know that shit by heart. I'd be like, yeah, my family went here, I'd know that. If you've got this document and you don't know it, you've never looked at it because you're not interested.
No.
Okay.
It does not interest me in migration.
That makes sense to me. That was me being sarcastic.
I know, I ain't that stupid.
If you feel like we're a bit rough, we don't mean to be rough.
I've been here before, it's fine, don't worry.
It's just that the identical theft, the identity theft, and the war is very strong on us. Yeah? So, sometimes, we can be a bit finger.
Go for it.
Obviously, we don't want a problem that we're not trying to be... I'm not trying to start an issue.
I understand. You won't understand. I understand. Don't worry. You have to know it's fine.
Yeah,
I enjoy doing this. If I didn't, I won't come.
We're finding out our heritage. And I've literally been for the last 5 years researching intensively where we come from. I've even found that the Irish, the original Irish, were black people. Right? And the Scottish, they were black people. That's how they became. You've got these black people in the Caribbean with Irish names. I'm a Murphy. Yeah. I wondered where the hell that I got the Murphy from.
Seamus Murphy, at least.
But the point is that those black people got to the Caribbean. They came with their original names, and you can find those names in Oliver Cromwell's, documentation of who the people he deported. Yeah, I've just been to the British Library to get a book called Whence the Black Irish of Jamaica. It says it right in there that those black people in the Caribbean are Irish. Because in Jamaica there are no such people who had landowners who would have been the slavers, they didn't have those names.
Where did the black Irish come from?
They literally came from Spain, right? They were called the Iberians, yeah? Because Spain used to be called the Iberian Peninsula, yeah?
David, it's been very great. Lovely. It's
a pleasure meeting you, right?
Very informative.
David.